BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
You're listening to Thursday's episode of The Archers from BBC Radio 4.
So, in the absence of dear, dear Larry, we have our own Oliver Awards.
Here we go. Ian's cracked open some bubbly.
Oh, lovely.
What a treat.
Which are specially for Borsetshire's most mysterious thespians. Our very own Ambridge Loveys.
Well, speak for yourself, Alan.
Yeah, I will, Roy. Because God is love. Therefore, by definition, we clergy are lovies too. Now, I'm looking forward to presenting these much-coveted awards, but I don't want to open the wrong envelope or read out the wrong name, as has been done in some, shall we say, less prestigious ceremonies. So I hope you'll bear with me for one tiny moment. Now, who swiped my glasses?
Kirsty's got the post-production, post-year blues, I reckon.
We're all suffering from that.
Yeah, she said she's struggling to see the point of celebrating.
Kirsty Miller, positivity only, if you please. That was the underlying theme of our show, after all.
Don't worry, Linda. I will positively try and enjoy myself.
Good.
Oh, by the way, your dad's at the back with Neil.
Yeah, I know. I saw him.
Mike's been golden, Linda. Every corner, every appliance at Willow Farm is now fully functional and perfectly tuned. Oh. The whole house is purring. Oh.
Well, I loved catching up with Vicky and Bethany.
Oh, right. Spectacles located, eyesight restored. Let the silliness commence.
At last!
You enjoying it, the dog walking?
Oh, keeps me fit, gets me out into nature. What's not to like?
Oh, the cold, the rain, the early mornings.
Thanks for the support, Alice.
No, I'm joking.
I know. And that's brilliant, because it means maybe you're feeling the tiniest bit stronger.
I guess, yeah. I think I'm starting to feel more positive, thanks to you.
Oh, no, don't start that again. I'll be leaning on you one day.
Well, you've got your own problems.
This is my solution. Oh, I love dogs. They always boost my mood. Plus, I'm really busy, so I'm not dwelling on stuff.
Sounds perfect.
Alice! I'm here.
Oh, hey, Jennifer!
Oh, isn't it rather late for dog walking?
Flexibility's my middle name.
Is it indeed? Well, good for you. Now, I'm doing a late supper, Alice. Is that all right? Thai stir fry?
Oh, sounds yummy.
I hope so. I'm just popping to Gran's with some slippers I ordered for her.
Yeah, no problem.
You're right, darling. She's looking a bit peaky, don't you think, Amy?
She always looks way better than me. So if she's peaky, I hate to think what I am.
Nonsense. You look wonderful, Amy. No, you do.
Send Gran my love, won't you?
Yes, of course. Shall I say you'll drop in next week?
Yeah, thanks, Mum. That'd be nice.
See you later, then. Bye, girl.
Cheerio. You know, you are looking a little bit better than yesterday, Alice.
Well, I hope so. What happened in the playground? Well, I guess it's progress, isn't it?
100%.
So there we go. That's Lily Pargeter, winner of the most cleverly disguised thermal underwear award. Never has such an apparently flimsy king outfit been quite so toasty.
I still can't believe that Rex missed out on the wrong character, wrong scene award. His Roman armour was clearly visible right through the Last Supper.
I know. His disciple's robe came open in quite an unfortunate way.
No, Leonard was a worthy winner. He took his lame man limp right through his scene as Joseph of Arimathea. Jill was trying so hard not to laugh.
It wouldn't have been so bad if he'd actually kept limping with the same leg.
I'm just pausing the award giving to read something out. Here we go. It's the letter of the week, which will appear in the Echo soon. It was written by the Bishop, who very much enjoyed the Ambridge Mystery Plays, as you all know. I'll skip the first bit, but there's a couple of sentences I'd like to share now. Oh, where is it? Yada, yada, yada.
Good job the bishop's not here.
Ah, here we are. Although I have preached the story of Christ all my life, when at dusk I stood on the green in Ambridge, warmly wrapped up from the chill January wind, I witnessed all the wonder of Christ's passion and was moved to tears. It was as if I had seen it afresh. I raise my mitre to the community spirit of Ambridge, to the wonderful production and the superb script, better even than the version penned by the illustrious Colin Whitstable.
Linda!
Well done!
Yes! Take that, Evangeline Lowminster!
So, moving straight on to our next important gong, and it's for the Best Stealing of a Scene Award, which of course involved our esteemed First King gliding in on a flatbed truck. So, it's another gong for the one and only Susan Carter!
I still can't believe how close I came to... well, ruining everything again.
I know.
If I'd actually opened the bottle...
Yeah, but you didn't. You stopped yourself.
Yeah, but there's going to be so many more tests like that. Worse than that. Any moment, anywhere, waiting to... jump out and grab me. And that's going to be for the rest of my life.
But hopefully you'll learn to avoid the triggers. And we'll be here to help you. Won't we, Daisy?
Thanks.
Well, I will be. Not sure Daisy's got more than 6 months in her.
Amy!
Well, we said we were going to be honest.
You're terrible.
No. Well, I am enjoying what I'm doing. I haven't felt this free for ages.
It's obviously doing you good. I think that's what I need. I've got way too much time on my hands.
Oh, good news, by the way. Dad's just told Kenton he'll help revarnish the outdoor benches at the ball.
Oh, that's kind of him.
Yeah, so he's staying for another few days.
Oh, Phoebe's will be made up. She's dying to spend some quality time with him.
Yeah.
Oh, Linda, I think Oliver wants you.
Sorry?
He's waving.
Oh, of course.
Ah, yes. This is the perfect time.
What for?
I'm on my way. Excuse me. Yes, excuse me.
Where's she going? Linda?
Well, apparently there's one more award.
And she's presenting it.
Oh, right. I didn't realise.
Yes. Good evening. Thank you. Bit of hush, please. Sorry to interrupt this magnificent buffet. Thank you, Ian. But we have one final, very important award. It's for calmest and most long-suffering producer of all time. And I don't need to open an envelope to see who won, because everyone already knows.
Yeah, she's right here.
What?
And I'd like her to join me on stage, please.
Oh, no.
Go on, Kirsty, up you go.
Oh, why didn't you warn me?
What would have been the fun in that?
Come on, she's waiting.
Oh, all right, I'm coming.
Here we are. Very well deserved, Kirsty.
Thank you. You really didn't have to.
Oh! Did you all hear that? She says, we didn't have to. Oh, typical Kirsty, I think you'll agree. Yes, we did have to, because you have been an absolute rock for this show and for everyone else, in fact. Your calm leadership...
Oh, that wasn't leadership.
The plays wouldn't have happened without you. So, yes, it was.
Of course it was. Your calm leadership and kindness... were a constant strength for us all. And it has been a very great privilege working with you.
Speech! Speech!
Oh, you're kidding.
A few words from our esteemed producer.
Thank you, Linda. And thanks to all of you. Except Roy, or should I call him Judas, who deliberately omitted to tell me this was happening or I'd have worn a posh frock.
That is your posh frock.
Oh, and he is Judas. Anyway, all I'll say is this year's Ambridge production has made me realise that not only can I endure pretty much anything...
Indeed.
...and put up with pretty much anyone, you know who you are, but I can simultaneously have an absolute blast. So, whatever happens in the future, I can confidently say that thanks to you all, and especially Roy, I'm now pretty much ready for anything. Let's raise our glasses for a special toast. To Ambridge!
To Ambridge!
Oh, where on earth?
Hey, Mum. You lost your keys?
Oh, they're in here somewhere. Do you have yours, Alice?
Oh, yeah, sure. Do you think we could have a quick word out here?
What is it, darling?
The thing is, you're right. I am feeling a bit peaky.
Oh, I knew it. I'm trying my best not to fuss over you, darling, but I could tell something was wrong.
It's been tough the last few days, and... well, every day's a struggle anyway.
I'm sure.
But it's worse, because I haven't really got a focus at the moment.
Martha's your focus, surely?
Yes, but I've got hours and hours on my own without anything to think about, except how I mustn't have a drink. Amy was talking today about the dog walking and how it helps her mentally, you know? And I realise that's probably what I need too.
Something to distract you.
Something with a purpose. Otherwise, all I keep thinking is, what's the point of me?
Oh, now that's rubbish, Alice.
Yeah, I know, but it's how I feel sometimes. And that's when things get, well, dangerous for me.
Oh, I see. Lillian was on the phone earlier worrying about you. It must have been very upsetting at the stables with Christopher. Look, if you want to talk about it, or if I can help in any way...
Well, actually, that's what I wanted to say, Mum. I think... no, I'm sure I'd be more resilient if I had other things going on in my life.
Uh-huh.
Look, what I'm saying is I feel it might do me good to get back to work.
Work?
I know it can be stressful.
Well, extremely. That's what you must avoid.
But not doing things, not being busy, not having a function, that's even more stressful.
Oh, Alice.
I've worked hard all my life, haven't I?
I know, but even...
I've got a good brain, but I'm not using it. Working is what I'm used to. It's part of me.
Okay.
So I wondered about maybe getting some part-time hours back at Home Farm.
Do you think you're ready for that?
It's what I've grown up with, and I think I'd feel confident and safe working there.
Yes.
Look, I mean, it's only an idea.
Right, darling. Yeah, I do understand. Look, leave it with me and I'll discuss it with your father.
Thanks, Mum. I really think this could be what I need to get my life back on track.